Okay.
And then.
Then after that, done for the day.
And the morning.
What about?
What time?
Man, I didn't know there were so many journalists under
11.
All the
11.
For what?
For a radio program.
Well. You know.
I don't know. I want to know what do you think.
Yeah. It's just
what time do you wake up?
Well, I mean, I'll be up around 10.
Why don't we just start at 1 and end at 3? Because you've got a show to do. You've got a long rehearsal, sound check tomorrow, to rehearse with those guys.
Yep.
Then you should have dinner and then just chill a little before you do it.
Yeah.
Can we do that? You start at 1 and end at 3? 1, 3? For the day? Is that good?
Yes.
I know you don't like it, but we love you anyway.
And if this important radio can need to make the interview in another time, but it's important.
You know, for me, it's okay to do. It's the number of things.
Right, how many.
You know?
If we keep it to 2 or 3, we're okay. If we do 5, 6, 7, then we'll go do a show after a long time, so we can meet up before we even start. Maybe if you want to push it to the next day, or Saturday, we take off.
What
time
do you have lunch? About
7.
And dinner 7.
Sure.
6, 7.
6, 7.
You know, we're going to have dinner at 6. Do you want to do them on Friday, couple? Just space them out a little? Can we do that?
Yeah.
You know, tomorrow do 2 or 3, and then Friday do a couple? Friday? Okay. Tell you what, go when you get a chance, work it out, write down a schedule, and we can talk about it later. We'll try to get it done.
Slowly,
okay.
Because we don't speak English too well.
Danielle, could I get a cafe? Cafe?
You want coffee?
Yeah, and agua also. And a cookie. Oh, cookie.
This is not your first time here, no? In one of
no.
I think you were here 3 times.
Is it 3?
Maybe.
Yeah, I know we have been at least 2 times.
3 times.
3? Good.
I think, yes.
Once with Robert Cray?
Yes, you played before Robert Cray the last time that you were here.
Yeah.
You played before Robert
Cray. Also, maybe with Lyle May?
In 1992 or 91, you were here. Before Lyle May.
Before?
The keyboard.
Yeah.
Player.
Yeah.
What is the relation? The relationship? What's the relationship between music and work?
Music and work?
Yes. Is it work for you? Music?
Or maybe you can combine the work and the pleasure to play.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm a musician first.
Yeah, that's a good one.
And I work for a living.
So, all the time.
All the time?
Todo el tiempo.
All the time? You work for it all the time, or you work for pleasure too?
Well, they're intertwined. I mean, I'm a musician, and I have to make a living. So, fortunately, I'm able to make a living making music.
Y la relación entre música y placer.
And what is the relationship between the pleasure of playing and the duty to play?
And the what?
And the work to play.
Well, I mean, I really don't know how to answer your question.
No puedo responder a...
I mean, you know.
Okay. You are going to play things from your last record, va a tocar sistemáticamente.
Sí, sí.
Supernatural.
Yeah, but I'll also play music from, you know, several of my older recordings as well.
También va a tocar
sí,
de
yo sí.
You still play with the Blue Line?
No. Tom Breckline is with me.
The drummer.
Yeah.
El baterista solamente de la banda que tenía que es la Blue Line.
But
Ross Colbeck, no.
No.
No. El baterista Ross Colbeck no está.
Tengo los nombres.
Yeah. Jimmy Earl is the bassist now.
El baterista es Jimmy.
And we have, thank you. And some water.
Dijo que no, se ocurría nada, pero medio complicado responderlo. What can you tell us about your experience playing with Tony Mitchell, for example? You were very young, no?
Yeah, I was, I was 22. Yeah. And you know, it was the greatest musical experience of my life. Even to this day.
With responsibility.
Responsibility?
To responsibility. It was very hard for you to play with them.
Yeah.
Very what?
Very hard.
Hard. Well, it was a new musical situation for me, something I was not familiar with. So it was a learning experience from the beginning. And at first, it took a while for me to relax. Yeah. But they were all very supportive of me, and they helped me.
You play with Tony Mitchell and then with George Harrison?
Yeah.
In that order.
That's right.
In which album of George Harrison do you appear?
I'm on Dark Horse.
Dark Horse.
Sí.
Dark Horse. You play whole album? Whole
just two songs.
Esa relajación que le costó encontrar ahora cuando toca solo con su banda, ¿cómo es? O sea, que ya entra relajado. Quiero buscar el camino del goce, digamos, ¿cómo él disfruta eso?
It's a very hard question.
What? What's that? Oh, hard to answer.
So, he wants to know if you, now at this time you are relaxed and playing, if the experience of that moment helps you to play more relaxed at this
in
moment.
General, yeah. Yes, because I was playing with musicians who were higher, more evolved than I was. So I learned how to be comfortable, and I learned how to play in a new musical context.
Some.
Yeah. So, you know, then that boosts your confidence, you know, when you finally feel like, okay, you know, I fit, I'm able to do this. I always felt challenged when I was working with Joni. It was never, you know, I could never take a single moment lightly, because the music was very fresh, you know, very unique. Like there was no precedent for it.
Oh yeah.
So every moment was kind of new. So you had to stay alert.
Que debía estar siempre muy compenetrado porque las cosas eran complejas. Siempre había algo para resolver.
So yeah. So that's a growing experience.
Es una experiencia que me hizo crecer.
And helps you in your future. Like now.
You are coming directly from Los Angeles?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a long way.
Yeah.
Long way. How many times? 24 hours.
I got up in the morning And I arrived at my hotel 24 hours later.
Y dejó el hotel allá, ya hace 24 horas, es el día que está viajando.
And I didn't sleep.
Y no durmió.
I slept maybe 1 hour on the,
no,
on the
not
flight.
Not on the flight. Oh, no?
So today, though, since we arrived at 12, so I just, I got about 2.5 hours sleep.
Así es la vida del músico.
That's the kind of life that music must.
It's a part.
It's part of it.
Part of it.
It's part of my part.
Sometimes it's not difficult. You know, it's smooth and pretty easy. Other times it's very hard. Usually in the summer when you go to Europe, because you spend every day you're going to the airport. What's that?
And your family was you're married, no?
Yeah.
No,
I mean,
time.
No children.
No.
So that makes it easier.
Bueno, pero está aquí trabajando y su mujer está allá, porque están separados por su trabajo.
He's there in Los Angeles.
Well, we live outside of Los Angeles.
Está fuera en este momento.
Small town, kind of in the country.
He's a singer, no? He's a singer.
Yes.
Es el cantante.
Yeah. She has a web page now.
Él está acá, su mujer está en Estados Unidos. ¿Cómo es eso? You are here, your wife is in USA.
Yeah.
It's difficult.
No? It's okay.
It's easy for you?
Well, you know, you get used to it to some extent. I mean, you know, my wife and I have been married for 15 years. So, you know, it was harder in the earlier part, you know. But now, it's a way of life, you know. She understands. I understand.
No problem.
Not really.
No.
Not really. It's we've worked all that out, you know, over time. I try not to be gone quite as long as I used to go away, you know. So I'm home a little more, and then certain times I have to travel more, and it's okay.
Van complementando. No es esa él también. Do you know something about the music of this country, about musicians from this country?
I do not. I don't. I've heard a little bit from friends that I met in California who were from Argentina. I even recorded with an Argentinian artist in Los Angeles in the like 1980s. But, you know, I'm very much a traditionalist with American music. I really like blues, jazz, and Western classical music. Those are the things I listen to the most.
Es lo que más escucho, jazz, blues, lo que es música americana. You didn't hear nothing about Piazzolla, for example?
Oh, yeah.
Yes?
I have one of his records.
Escucho algo de Piazzolla.
He's brilliant. Dino Saluzzi.
Dino Saluzzi,
yeah. I recorded with Dino.
Bandoneon.
Yeah. I recorded with him with...
Grabó con él,
¿eh?
Ricky Lee Jones.
Ah, Ricky Lee Jones, the singer.
Yeah.
Grabó un disco con Ricky Lee Jones. Es una cantante.
Yeah. With Dino, myself, and Charlie Hayden on bass.
Charlie Hayden,
jazz
bass.
We did an album called Pop Pop.
Samaldisco.
Yeah. Ricky Lee Jones.
Yeah, Ricky Lee Jones. It's una cantante.
It's right about 1991.
92. And you have played with Pino Marrone. He's a guitar player from this country.
Uh-huh.
Pino Marrone.
Uh-huh.
You know him?
I remember that name. Pino Marrone.
Yes.
I played with him.
He was studying there with Claudio.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Pino Marrone is a guitarist.
Yeah, these are some of the people I met in Southern California, yeah.
Yes. He really liked jazz style.
Yeah. I remember him.
Sí, no, 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 no Do you think, for example, for a child of you, of yours, the musician career, do you want that your child could be a musician?
Sure. I think being a musician is just as good a profession as any other profession. No problem. And better in many ways because of travel.
Y mejor en algunos aspectos que otros.
You get a bigger world view. It helps you understand the world, you know.
Todo
el mundo.
Yeah.
You are going to give a clinic on Monday.
Buenos Aires?
Yeah.
Okay. No.
I'm doing Monday. Daniela knows. I'm not sure when the other one is.
Quartet,
and we have our first rehearsal together tomorrow.
mañana va a ser el primer concierto que van a hacer juntos mañana.
But he knows the music.
Pero él conoce la música.
It'll be great, no problem.
No hay problema, es grande.
It will be actually especially fun.
Eso es lo que lo hace especialmente motivo.
Yeah.
Motivado.
I think so.
Well, well,
thank you for
my pleasure.
You have played with Jaco Pastorius?
Only a little. I recorded with Jaco, with Joni Mitchell.
With Joni Mitchell, you have recorded with him?
Yeah, but it didn't go on the record.
Grabó con Jaco Pastorius y Joni Mitchell, pero no fue editado.
But I'm the person who introduced Jaco's music to Joni.
Él fue introducido por Jaco a Joni Mitchell.
So I felt proud of that.
Well, okay. That works.
It's okay?